Welcome to my educative channel. Today I'm going to speak about Asian eyelid rejuvenation. I'm not to talk about Asian eyelid occidentalization, just only rejuvenation. I left my curriculum. The eyelid of Asian has its own unique characteristics. The Asian people live and travel through various climatic zones, exposing them to high wind, dust, storm. Some experts assert that the thick fat pads common in Asian eyelid develop due to the exposure to extreme temperature changes. The fat pads could be useful for keeping the brow warm during the winters and cool during the summers. Let's go to see the anatomy of the Asian upper eyelid. As we can see here, this is the skin, this is the orbicular oculi muscles, and the characteristic of Asian, they have more fat under the skin, more fatty under the orbicular muscles, and also have more fat in the preaponeurotic area. All this fat from the submuscular and the preaponeurotic don't let the orbicularis, the elevator, go into the dermis and produce the typical crease that we have the occidentals. Here we can see the fat pads, and these fat pads prevent the eyelid crease from forming. The rejuvenation of Asian eyelid surgery involves removing the excess fat tissue and skin that cause the eyelid look heavy, puffy, or aged. In some cases, this surgery is needed to expand the field of the vision that exceeds tissue block. Asian upper eyelid skin is generally thicker than Caucasian. This fact explains the natural result created by traditional blepharoplasty. We can see the excess of thicker skin there. For this reason, many plastic surgeons that treat this kind of patient prefer remove the eyebrow skin like this. I'm going to present a new alternative to the Asian eyelid rejuvenation. First, let me do a thorough clinical evaluation of the patient. The upper eyelid crease is not as apparent as the crease of Caucasian eyes. These patients have a low eyelid crease, low seated nasally taper. The upper lid looks puffier and has more fullness. The palpebral fissure is narrow, has a mild ptosis. Asian upper eyelid skin is generally thick than Caucasian. Lower lid cheek. This patient have a lower lid cheek junction, like we can see here. Here we can see the excess of the fat of the lower eyelid. The tear through. A strong forward projection of the zygomatic arch. This patient lost the golden proportion. We can see a vertical oval here. The golden proportion is when the pupil is in the middle of the oval, right here. We can see the distance from here to here is short, and the distance from here to here is long. This patient looked sad, old, tired, and when we made a good work in the upper eyelid and malar area, we can get this natural and beautiful result. How do I get this golden proportion? A stab incision is performed in the upper inner part of the upper eyelid. Through this incision, it is possible to remove the inner and lateral fat pads that produce a puffiness in the patient. We assess the lower eyelid fat bags through a transcangential incision like we see here. The lower eyelid fat pads are repositioned to the malar area. The upper and lower eyelid skin is tightening and rejuvenated with carbon dioxide laser as we see here. We can see the contraction of the skin. The benefits of this novel technique are the following: no scars, natural results. We can see a change of the position of the eyelid junction. We can see the cheek voluminization. The upper eyelid fat removal and skin tightening increase the field of the vision. The upper eyelid fold is a little higher in the post-operative view. The palpebral ptosis was improved. It's natural because the tightening of the skin and the removal of the heavy fat pads produce this. We can see the big change this procedure can produce. I hope you enjoy this presentation. My team and I wait for you in Buenos Aires, Argentina. And you can make your consultation, send us a WhatsApp or an email with your pictures and also what do you want to improve. In my website I have several videos, almost 1,300 videos, and you can see different kind of patients and you can see the results. And if you have any doubts, please send us your email, photos, and we can help you to come to Argentina. Most of the patients perform their pre-studies in their countries and send us to check if everything is okay. Depending on the surgery is the time of stay in Buenos Aires. Buenos Aires is a cosmopolitan city, it's very nice, at this moment very cheap, and if some patients have 2, 3, 4 days of the recovery and go to see the city and others go outside to the Patagonia, the waterfall, the north. We are waiting for you. Send us information, send us pictures, and we can keep in touch.